It's Jenny Town. Featuring special guest appearances by Amy Millan and Evan Cranley of Stars. And Lance SAMPSON, otherwise known as AQUAKULTURE.
Just a moment, please. Bird, no need to cry. We're about to start the show. Welcome to Jennytown. So, everybody, these are my favorite chocolate chip cookies to make. Soft almond baked cookies, and my friend Rose Cousins gave me the recipe, and I've been making them for like 2 years as my top choice cookie. Usually, I just put a whole bunch of stuff in a bowl and mix it around and put it in the oven, and then that's the cookie. But this is an actual recipe, and I wrote it down, and we're gonna make it together. First things first, almond flour. I love almond flour because, well, it's made of almonds. I love almonds. And, you know, it just doesn't make me feel really gross, and it's got so much protein, so I feel like whenever I would eat these cookies, yeah, I do still have a lisp from my braces, that's true. But they say it'll only last a few weeks. But I'm kind of getting used to it, and I'm kind of okay with it, you know what I mean? Okay, whenever I would eat these cookies, I never even noticed the lisp, really, until I start talking and it, like, matters what I'm saying. Okay, when I would eat these cookies, I would be like, I feel like I just got an energy boost, you know? Not like when you eat a cookie, you're like, this is so good, and then I'm like, I have, like, regressive shame or whatever. Like, I'm working on that anyway. We all are, right, ladies, men? Okay, but these are just, I'm not gonna say guilt-free because there shouldn't be any guilt when you're trying to eat a cookie. Just eat a cookie! But these cookies just make me feel really good! Are these life-inspiring cookies? Should we rename them? Okay, 2 cups of almond flour. 1. I do know that this almond flour is a little bit expensive. For a while, I was just trying to make almond flour. I was like, I got things I gotta do. Also, preheat the oven at 375. Preheated. So it says 2 tablespoons of hard coconut oil. There, that's 2 tablespoons. Okay, use that as a moisturizer. Gentlemen friends, if you've got a beard, just rub it into your, just rub that in, your coconut beard. Okay, just, it's gonna be so good. Or even your face. Everywhere. Give yourself a massage. Self-care! Oh, God. Oh, I feel so much better. I literally just want to throw stuff. Like, I just want to go like, boom! But that's, because you know what? That's how we roll here. I'll pick that up, okay? I'm just going to put this in the microwave for like 30 seconds.
I'm microwaving!
This is a lipstick I got, and I love it. And there's just like all this dirt on it, because my kid also loves lipstick. I better check out coconut oil.
It's definitely melted.
Okay, use that as a little gloss. A little bit of dirt in that. See you later, makeup! Not gonna throw that. That's expensive, real stuff I need. So, I love this spoon. This was my mother's spoon. Okay, so we've got some coconut oil in there. Okay, honestly, I'm remembering now that you're maybe supposed to do the oil and the sugar and stuff first together, and I didn't do that. But I will leave the proper instructions after, but I'm pretty sure I've done it this way before and it's still worked out. Vanilla. Okay, 1 teaspoon. Now, I always bought real vanilla, but my sister-in-law, Jane Ledwell, is the best cook and the best baker, and she buys the artificial stuff, and I'm just like, if she is getting the artificial stuff, and then so am I. Like, I don't know. What is the difference, right? An egg. Put that in the compost. Salt. 1/4 of a teaspoon of salt. Now, yeah, you just want to add these things all together, and so basically what you probably want to do first is do the oil and maple syrup together and then the other stuff. But we've just added it all together. I think that the maple syrup is next. It's a party. Bird, what do you think? Bird's over there. 1/2 cup of chocolate chips. This is where we're at. Oh my God. It doesn't matter if you put them all in together at the same time or not. So here's the cookies. This one has a lot of chocolate chips in it and this one doesn't. So I'm just casually going to redistribute this selfish cookie, this greedy cookie, and put in with the other, just make them the same. So I can't remember if you're, I don't think you need to roll, like push them down or anything. So they look like this, they look like this, and they're gonna be so good.
Hey, Jennytown. How's it going? We're so excited to be on the Jennytown program. I'm here with Cranley Cooks. Oh, look at those skills. And he's gonna show all of us how to clean leeks, because it's almost leek season, and the leeks are gonna come in, and we're gonna clean them real nice. He's gonna show you right now. You wanna take that green bits off? Those aren't good?
Now what you want to do with the darker green bits is save it for your stock. Don't throw these away. Okay. You can freeze them or you can start a stock right away. We'll probably start a stock because we're having a bit of chicken. So this will be great for a chicken stock or vegetable stock. Then I cut the root end off. Also, you can save that for a stock, no problem. Now this is where you might want to zoom in here. That's a little... Looks like a little tough there. Not the nicest leek I've ever seen. But you know, Canada will be giving their leeks to us soon. Okay, what you want to do is then you cut the leek in half this way. And usually you'll see, most of the time you'll see sand that piles up or dirt that piles up within the section of leek here. So this is what you do. You want to just kind of open the folds here.
Open the folds.
Who doesn't like an open fold? And then you just wash them like this. Make sure there's no dirt in there.
No dirt in there.
In the summertime and late in the spring, you'll definitely get dirtier leeks. And again with the other leek here.
Clean that up.
Open the folds.
I can smell them. They smell really good. Yeah. I'm Jennytown. We're cleaning some leeks. Cleaning some leeks. Look at the flowers, they're so pretty. Cleaning some leeks.
And we're cleaning leeks, and that's kind of it, really. You can pat them down. I'm gonna kind of look at this leek here. Maybe I'll just save that for the stock.
Good idea. And what are you gonna do with the leeks tonight?
Oh, I'm gonna braise them with some chicken, kale, and some cannellini beans. Finish that whole thing in the oven. And you know what? Maybe we'll show you the finished product when we're done with our leeks.
Amazing. Yeah, come check us out on Cranley Cooks too. We got all sorts of stuff on there. Love you, Jennytown.
Clean in the folds, Jennytown.
Bye, Jennytown. Leeks.
Hello, Danny? Yeah, you do need a haircut. Should we make this happen? I'm ready, come on up. Here's the truth. This is an experiment, okay? So I can quickly watch a YouTube video. Danny! Okay, Danny, welcome. Welcome to Jennytown, you're my first official guest. So usually when you give a haircut to someone, you get them to take off their shirt and you wrap them in a towel. And I brought a towel if you're interested. Okay? So please take off your clothes. Take your shirt off.
Taking one shirt off.
What? So what we'll do here, what happens at the hairdresser? You don't take all your clothes off. Basically, I just brought a spray thing of water because I think that's easier for today. And what I did was I just added a few little drops of essential oil, peppermint essential oil. It's so good for your hair and smells good. What do you think? Do you like that?
I can't smell
it. Come on. I would love to just pour a small cup of water over your head, but that's probably not gonna happen. Right? Okay. So now the hair is completely wet and minty fresh. How do you feel, Danny? Does this feel like a self-care moment? No?
shorter on the sides.
Yeah, good.
But I want longer on the back.
Yeah.
And on the top.
Amazing.
Not a bit of a mullet scenario.
Got it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Great. I'm just going to vibe it out, basically. Do you trust me? Cool. This is going to be so great. Is everyone excited? And the crowd goes wild. If I had some sunglasses, I could do that thing where, you know, you put them there. So I'm thinking we'll cut. There'll still be like a really long bang if you cut it like that.
I don't like the word bang.
It's not a bang. It's not a bang.
It's Jenny Town, yeah, yeah. Whether you want a two or three or him or they or she, we care. You know you're welcome here, yeah, in Jenny Town. Yeah, 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 in Jenny Town. You're free to be you, so take off your shoes, sit on the floor, it's time to get down. Just like it's rock and roll, yeah, in Jenny Town.
It's Jenny Town.
Hello, my name is Lance SAMPSON, professionally known as AQUAKULTURE, and this is my heritage moment. Boxing is a staple in my father's side of the family. I've had a few famous boxers in my family lineage. My father, Donnie Johnson, was a pro boxer. My great-uncle Tiger Warrington became the Canadian light heavyweight champion in 1935 and was inducted into the Nova Scotia Sports Hall of Fame. I didn't really like to compete myself, so I started training in shadow boxing, practice that also has its roots in Nova Scotia. July 29th, 1870, George Dixon was born in Acreville, Nova Scotia, was the first Canadian-born boxing champion, and ranked the number one featherweight champion of all time. With a total of 163 fights, 74 wins, 36 knockouts, 30 losses, 55 draws, 6 no contests, George Dixon was a beast. Shadow boxing is an exercise used in training for combat sports, mainly to prepare the muscles before the training begins. Muhammad Ali once performed a now famous routine next to Howard Cosell, and our George Dixon, born on July 29, 1870, is widely credited for developing that technique. The only way I could break this thing was to listen
to me.
How do you take a vacation? Well, maybe you can just go outside and even if it's a bit rainy, you can make a sit-upon. A sit-upon is basically, you just take a garbage bag or recycling. I think I'm gonna go with the white. It's sort of a clear white and it's just like a little more simple. We used to make these and just fill them with stuff and then sit on them. I'm just gonna use some stuff that I found laying around, like this coat. And a sweater. I'm just gonna put it inside. I'm just gonna pack it together. There's no sewing required. And you just tie a knot. And then basically, you've got your sit-upon. So if you're just outside and you need to sit on something, you got a vitamin C, that's amazing. You can just sit on it. It's incredibly comfortable. We were gonna have a special guest on today, and instead of that, we're having my family because of COVID and because our childcare is also canceled. So, okay, the big cookie reveal is gonna happen now. I'm not sure if Danny's, do you want your own sit-upon? Do you want me to just sit on it? It's incredibly comfortable. Look at these cookies! Oh my goodness.
Please.
Gus, would you like to have a cookie?
Yeah, please. Yes, please.
Here you go, sweetheart. You can take the whole thing. And would you like a cookie? And also, it's the hair reveal. Check it out. Hank's gonna have a little bite.
Oh yeah.
Oh dear.
So yeah, we weren't gonna have family on today, but lucky us, we're all together.
On vacation.
Oh my God, we're on vacation.
A working vacation. Is this mine too?
I don't know.
Hank ate mine.
That's a half cup of chocolate chips. I think I could go less.
I like a lot of chocolate chips.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first chocolate ever.
He's just only eating pure breast milk and chocolate. It's crazy. You can make your own vacation. Just put on a hat. And just have a snack outside. And it's a vacation. Make a sit upon.
Rising up back on the street, did my time, took my chances, went the distance, now I'm back on my feet, just a man and his will to survive. So many times it happens too fast, you trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rivals. And the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, and he's watching us all in the eye. Eye of the tiger. Face to face, out in the heat, hanging tough, staying hungry. They stack the odds till we take to the street, for we kill with skill to survive. Rising up straight to the top, had the guts, got the glory. Went the distance, now I'm not gonna stop. Just a man and his will to survive. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival. And the last known survivor stalks his prey in the night, and he's watching us all in the eye. Eye of the tiger.
Sign up for Patreon, because that way I will be able to have enough money to do this as a job? What? $5 a month? Come here, bird. Come on, guys. And then what? We can just stay here in this woodland and create entertainment for you? I would love that. So, let me hear. And let me see. What is the other thing you wanted to say? Charlie, what was it? Charlie, tell me. Okay, sign up for Patreon if you love this. Subscribe to YouTube if you love it, and it's free other than that. If you subscribe, or if you do Patreon, it's like, you can pay $5. That's awesome. But if you can't, then somebody else on Patreon has got your back. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry about this, bird.
Jenny Town.